Hello and welcome to StarnFX. My name is Eran, and in this tutorial I'll show you how to match colors and create a light drop effect using only built-in tools in After Effects. So we're going to start using this lovely dancer showing her hip-hop act against this colorful portal. I already took care of the green screen using the key light effect as well as pre-composed this layer, so we don't need to worry about the alpha channel. Now before I'll show you how to create the light drop effect, I want to match her to the changing background, and I'll do this using the color link effect. So I'll make sure the layer is selected, and then I'll go to effect, color correction, and choose the color link effect. I need to set the source layer here, so I'll select the colorful portal, and then I'm also going to tick Stencil Original Alpha, and this is going to punch a hole using the alpha channel of this layer. Next, I'll change the blending mode. I recommend to start with either soft light or maybe even overlay, and then play with the opacity. So I'll set the opacity to 50%, and if I'll play the result, you can see that this effect is going to link between the colors of the background and the foreground. And in this case, when the background colors are changing frequently, it's actually doing a very nice job. All right, but now we need to make it even more convincing by creating this light wrap effect. Now, light wrap can help you composite objects into a very bright background by wrapping or spilling light from the background onto the foreground object. And my recipe to create it without the use of third-party tools is to duplicate the background. So I'll select it over here and press Command or Control D. I'll place it above the foreground layer, and then under Effect, Channel, I'll apply the Set Matte effect. I'll take the matte from the Hip Hop Dancer layer and I'll invert it. I'm also going to solo the layer for a moment so we can see what we are doing just for this layer. And then I'll add the Fast Box Blur effect by visiting the Blur and Sharpen category and choosing it from here. I'll start with a value of 10, but of course you can change your mind later. This is going to determine how much spill is going to wrap around the edges. Now we need to just isolate the edge. So I'll select the Set Matte effect and press Command D, Control D if you're working on the PC, and duplicate another instance. I'll drag this one underneath the Fast Box Blur and take away the invert matte. And this will leave us just with the halo glow around the edges. So I'll take away the solo switch, and I'm also going to change the blending mode of this layer to screen and press spacebar to preview it. Now, if you want to exaggerate this effect, you could play with the blur radius. So if I'll raise this one to 20, then I'm basically creating a heavier light wrap effect. So depending on your needs, I'm going to set it to 15, and then I'll go to the beginning. I'll create an adjustment layer above everything. And to this adjustment layer, under the distort category, I'll add the transform effect. And this will help me to create a dolly in, pushing into the image. So I'll create a scale keyframe at the beginning, go to the end of this timeline and set it to, let's go with 135. Then I'll go to the beginning, maximize the composition viewer by pressing on the tilde key and preview the result. And that's it for this one. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this can help you with your own work. And as usual, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you again in the next one.